Michael, what's the best part of your game that you showed this afternoon for the Lakers?
Definitely my shooting ability. Came out and shot great in the drills. And then in terms of my other parts of my game, I tried to show that I can defend multiple positions. In the one-on-ones, I guarded the bigs, you know, guarded Terry, who's a point guard. So just try to incorporate all those things in my game and show them I can do a lot of things.
Byron Scott, a defensive-minded head coach, what are your main strengths defensively?
I feel like I can guard 1-3. You know, I did that in college, even guard the 4 sometimes. Coach trusted me to, you know, guard multiple positions. So, you know, my length and my athletic ability, I think that I can guard multiple positions in the NBA.
I'll test you if you've done your homework. Do you have a favorite all-time Laker? And if so, who and why?
Definitely Magic Johnson, because I think he was the greatest Laker ever. Also like James Worthy. I used to watch a lot of the Lakers games, you know, back in the day. My dad used to record them, and I used to watch them. We used to watch them together. But just what Magic was able to do with the ball, you know, in terms of his passing ability, you know, there's nobody else like him.
Is there a player, past or present, that you've studied film or you try and pattern your game after a little bit?
I would say probably Bradley Beal, just because I had a chance to work out with him a couple summers ago when he came back to Florida. We're about the same size, same athletic build, you know. And, you know, we can both shoot the ball very well. And I saw myself kind of doing the same things that he does to get his shot off and things like that. So I see that we have a lot of similarities in our game.
Have you given much thought to what it might be like to play with a great player like Kobe Bryant?
Yeah, man, it would be a great opportunity. You know, if I'm lucky enough to have the opportunity, I'm going to try and make the most of it, you know, work my tail off. I know that he demands a lot of his teammates. So, you know, I definitely respond to that well because I'm a self-starter. I'm a self-motivator. So, you know, that wouldn't be a problem for me.
Are you excited about everything that's going on in this draft process? And then the draft is less than a week away now.
Yeah, but I'm just trying to take it one day at a time, you know, not trying to look too far ahead in the future. I still got a couple workouts left, so I'm trying to finish out those strong.
Obviously, anybody who knows your game knows you can shoot the 3-ball. On average, how many shots you think you're getting up a day?
I mean, it's a little bit different now just because I'm traveling a lot of these workouts. But, you know, before I started, I was probably getting 500, 600 makes a day. You know, that's usually my average. I try and, you know, stay sharp. But I've worked myself up to that. You know, when I was little, I could barely make 100 threes in an hour. So, you know, I've definitely come a long way, but I like to keep my shot sharp. So I got to get them up every day.
You had a lot more playing time from your freshman to sophomore year, but like, what else do you think went into your increase in production?
Just my time in the gym, man. I stayed in the gym, you know. I was able to get a bigger opportunity to play a bigger role my sophomore year, and that's why my minutes jumped. But, you know, that whole summer I was just in the gym working my tail off. I knew that I was going to have an opportunity to increase my minutes, and I wanted to make the most of it, so that's what I did.
What skill do you have that will best translate into the NBA?
Definitely my shooting. I feel like I'm the best shooter in this draft, and whoever takes me is getting the best shooter in this draft. So I've shown that over the past 3 years of my career, so the numbers will speak for itself.